We're on the sixth floor of the Pickwick Mill, which is a restored flour grinding mill. This is the largest one in the state of Minnesota that has been restored. And it was also one of the first commercial businesses in the state of Minnesota. They actually got the mill running in 58. And they had 5 employees, and their annual payroll was $3,000 a year for the 5. They used to grind flour for the Union Army, and they ground 100 barrels a day, 24 hours a day. It was constructed with local timber and local stone. It was put together with no nails. A lot of the big beams are all notched and put together with wooden pegs. And down on the fourth floor and fifth floor, there's an iron tie bar that runs through from one side of the building to the other. And that tie bar's got a turnbuckle in the middle to tighten it up. And that's what held the building together when they were building it. Down on the third floor, there's a scale and a hopper. And they unloaded the grain into that hopper, and it was weighed. Once they weighed it, they opened the door in the bottom of that hopper. Everything went to the bottom floor here. And there's bucket conveyors that carried everything all the way up to the top floor. And then it goes across the wooden auger over here. And then it starts its journey back down. It depended on which way they wanted to go with it. And it had to make the trip back and forth more than once. When they used grinding stones, it actually had to make the trip about 4 times. When they used a roller mill, it just had to come up and go down to whichever mill they wanted. And then it got sifted out, and then they had their flour. Back during the war years, a lot of that equipment out of some of these mills got scrapped out for metal for the war. We were fortunate this one did not get that death, mainly because they were still grinding livestock feed here. The equipment was here. If we didn't have that, we wouldn't have any place to start because you can't get it. This building was in really bad shape. And they were going to tear it down, but some of the local families go way back to when this building was built. And so they had a desire to save it. That's why they formed Pickwick Mill Incorporated. And we've worked on it since 1980, getting it restored. We've got it to the point now that when we have groups and bus tours, we do run all the machinery on all 6 floors with the water wheel. The water wheel itself, we built that in 96. That is 4 feet wide, is 20 feet high. When it's loaded and working heavy, each one of those steps will hold 240 pounds of water. They had dragged the old wheel out about the turn of the century, and they put a water turbine out there because that wouldn't freeze up as bad in the wintertime as a wheel. But when we started to restore, they took the water turbine out because people don't want to see that. They want to see a wheel going around. So we got the plans from the National Organization of Mills on how to build a water wheel, and we built it right back here. And that's where we get all the leverage to run all the machinery on all 6 floors. We just run everything for display purposes. We do not grind. If we did, every mouse in the country would probably know about it. We get a lot of school kids in here, and we do get people in here from all over the world. But if you speak slowly and use your hands, we usually get by pretty good. A little over a month ago, we had an international group here from 6 different countries. That's all they do is go around and tour mills. The best part was when they sent us a thank you note, they sent it in 6 different languages. It's done with volunteers and donations. We've got 240 members. I try to keep volunteers lined up because we're open 6 days a week here during the summer. We do have several local people that do volunteer to help us out. The names on all the steps and risers are people that have donated $100 towards the mill. It's just a way of saying thanks for doing it.
This program is funded by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money from the vote of the people of Minnesota on November 4th, 2008. And by the members of Prairie Public.